They were not sex slaves, they were prostitutes.
200,000 women.
They were actually kidnapped from their families, abducted.
Forced into sexual slavery.
日本軍がこんなことをするはずがないということは、もうすぐに私は直感しました。
Comfort ladies are nothing more than prostitutes or professional camp followers.
そういう資料の解釈は完全に間違っていると思います。
지난 5월 일본에서 개봉하면서 큰 반응을 불러일으키고 있다는 소식 저희 시사자께서 저희 소개해드린 바가 있는데 드디어 다음 주에 우리 한국에서도 개봉을 하네요. 자, 개봉을 앞두고 이 영화를 만든 미키 데자키 감독을 오늘 스튜디오에 초대했습니다. 어서 오십시오.
Hello, my name is Miki Dezaki. I am the director of Shusenjo. I'm happy to be here. Thank you.
With an estimated 200,000 women.
200,000 women.
200,000 women.
They were actually kidnapped from their families, abducted.
Kidnapped and forced to work.
Those women forced into sexual slavery by the Japanese army.
일본군 위안부, 일본군 성노예에 대해서는 언제 처음 아시게 된 것이고 이걸 영화로 만들어야겠다는 생각은 언제 하시게 된 건지?
Didn't really know about the issue until around 2014. I just had read a few articles on it, and yeah, I just thought it was horrible thing that maybe the Japanese military did. I really got interested in making a film about it is when I started doing research, and I realized that there's a difference between what Japanese people know and what Korean people know about the issue. And I thought maybe with a documentary film, I could maybe bring more context to the issue and hopefully, through that understanding, maybe Japanese and Korean people can become less hateful towards each other and maybe have better discussions about it.
제목의 주 전장, 그러니까 주된 전투 장소가 어디라는 얘기입니까?
Yeah, so I got that word from the far-right Japanese activists who are saying that America is the main battleground of the comfort women issue. And in their mind, they believe that if they can change American people's perspective on this issue, maybe they can change world history. So that's where I got the word main battleground from. But I thought of it more metaphorically. So I thought that my mind was kind of like the battleground when I was interviewing these people. They would constantly be trying to, persuade me to think the way they think, and then hopefully I would make a film for their perspective. And so basically I try to give this experience to the audience, so the audience's minds become kind of the main battleground for this issue.
So I approached them, and surprisingly they agreed to speak with me despite my being anti-Japanese in their eyes. These people are what some call historical revisionists or deniers.
이번 그 영화의 인터뷰에 응한 일본 극우 인사들 가운데 몇몇 사람이 자기들은 속았다, 편집이 잘못됐다, 영화 상영 중지 처분 요구한다 이렇게 공격을 퍼붓기도 했는데 그분들한테 한마디 하신다면?
I guess I'll see you in court. I think we have a very strong case. It's well known that, they want to say that they never knew that the film would be publicized or shown in theaters. However, when we told them that it was going to be shown in theaters, they sent me emails saying congratulations, and they even posted the trailer on their Facebook page. This is all before they actually saw the film. But this just proves that they knew that the film was going to be publicly released, and they were actually excited about it.
네, 일본의 한 다른 영화 감독이 이 영화 개봉된 후에 미키 데자키 감독 안전이 우려된다 이렇게 걱정한 이야기를 하기도 했는데 혹시 뭐 신변의 위협을 느낄 만한 일들은 없었습니까? 개봉 후에?
You know, there are people online who say, you know, I should die or things like that. And maybe the most severe threat so far has been somebody posting an address that was supposed to be mine. So, you know, I'm very aware that there are people out there who would like to hurt me in some way. However, I think that, you know, it's one thing for people to write something online. I think the people who write, you know, I'll kill you online are not the people who would actually do anything. It's the people who don't say anything but think that way quietly. So yeah, I'm very aware of the possibility of some kind of violence against me, but I'm very careful.
의견은 다를 수 있습니다만 사실, 진실은 하나 아니겠습니까? 방금 극우 세력들이 나름의 논리, 그러나 절대 다수의 성노예들이 강제로 속아서 성노예로 일본 군의 조직적 명령에 의해 수십 년 내지 수년간 그런 참혹한 생활을 했다는 것이 분명한 사실인데 뭐 극히 일부 있을지도 모르는 자발적 매춘설을 모든 위안부에게 적용하는 그 일본의 극우 세력들의 주장이 정말 그들은 그걸 믿고 있다고 생각이 되시는지?
Yeah, that's a really tough one. I would say that yeah, it's kind of maybe a mixture to some extent, but even if they do acknowledge that the women were deceived, they would put the responsibility not on the Japanese government and the military, but on the Korean brokers. So they may acknowledge that they were deceived, but they would say, well, that's not our responsibility. So yeah, I think fundamentally they just want to believe that their ancestors and, you know, grandfathers could never do anything so horrible as rape women or, you know, massacre people. So they will find whatever way to support that view.
怖い本当に怖いです彼らはですね明らかに戦前の日本を肯定しているし人権感覚がないし全裸平等教育とかあるいはその男女共同参画社会とかそういうものに対して反対でクロタゴ
그렇다고 강간 제도를 만든 거 그럼 일본 정부였다는 거죠.
It's one step in the process of eradicating sexual violence towards women and more forever. One, two.